I've been having dreams, splashing in the summer stream, tripping, I fall in. I wanted it to happen. My body turns to ice, crushing weight of paradise. Solid block of gold, lying in the cold. I feel right.
Welcome to the review of the RS3 app.
How am I so deep in love?
Right off the bat, I love the feel of this cube. I'll try to explain this as good as possible. The surface is kind of a matte finish, but it's grippy, like a semi-matte finish if you know what I mean. I kinda love it. It makes the cube feel less like a budget cube right off the box. Very good first impressions. Alright, let's slow things down and cover the specs. The 2020 RS3M comes in at an insanely low $10 and can be purchased at cubos.com through the link below. You can also save 5% off using the discount code LucasNull5 at checkout and also support the channel. It comes in at 55.7mm and weighs in at 86 grams. For comparison, the weight and size is almost exactly between the Volca Elite and the GTS3M. In the paper box, you'll find the standard Moya cards as well as a screwdriver, cube stand, an extra blue plastic piece, and the same tensioning tool you can find in the GTS3M and WRM. Very impressive for a $10 cube. Speaking of blue pieces and tensioning tools, this is to my knowledge the only budget 3x3 or even the only 3x3 under $20 that includes a real customization feature. It comes with the standard version of the spring compression system that we've seen before in Moya flagships such as the WRM. In short, you can use the included tool to turn the blue piece, and the higher it is, the more stable the cube is, and vice versa. I'll link JPerm's video below where he goes in depth of how it all works. Let's discuss the feel, which is for most people the most important. It's very smooth with a little bit of crunch. It feels like a mixture between a 356 GAN cube and the GTS3M. The crunchiness and matte feel from a GAN with the blocky feel from the GTS. Add some smoothness and you got yourself an RS3M. Okay, hold on. From what I've said, the cube sounds perfect, and to be honest, it's really not. There are some things that I didn't like out of the box. Keywords, out of the box. All of the problems I had could be fixed or solved very easily. First off, spring noise. Common with cheaper cubes, loop the springs, problem solved, moving on. Second, lockups and bad corner cutting. Little harder, but still doable. Tune the blue piece tighter, a couple of clicks, loop the pieces and you're done. Last but not least, weak magnets. This should be hard, but really it isn't. Here's why. For an extra $6, Cubos will install 24 magnets into each edge piece. Don't want to spend $6? For an extra $2.50, they will send 25 magnets with the cube and you can install them for yourselves. It couldn't be simpler. Open an edge piece, take a magnet and place them onto the pre-installed magnets. No glues required. Repeat this easy process for the remaining 11 edge pieces and you're done. Alright. So will this cube replace my $60 excess? The answer is a bit complicated, and I don't think replace is the right word to use. Is it worth it over the excess? Yes, anytime. Listen, from now on, if someone asks me what cube I should get, I will 95% of the time say this cube. For conclusion, you should definitely check out this cube if you're on the market for a 3x3, no matter your budget. It's that good. I'll also keep using this cube, but I'm not 100% sure if I will stick to it. Of course, the quality will not match the 6 times more expensive GAN flagship, but out of all the cubes I've tried and reviewed, this is by far the most value for the price. So if you guys enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed making it, thank you guys for watching, catch you guys in the next one, bye.